Well, hello everyone, I'm Jenny from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in Animallica. And 2 days ago, or well, yesterday actually, I think it was, they released a new update. So now it is alpha version 2.46a, actually, because there was a little hotfix that they released today too. They are always very fast at jumping right in and fixing anything that people report, especially when it is something critical, and this one kind of was, because it would keep people from getting out of the game again, or closing down the game properly and saving and all that. But they fixed it, and it should all be working fine again. So, a lot of stuff was actually changed with this update. Well, one thing is that the grass in the game, the grass rendering, has been changed to make the grass look more lush and natural, and well, I feel like I can already see a difference here. Did they add more flowers too or something? I'm not sure, I just feel like, wow, it doesn't seem like there's as many holes or whatever in this anymore, but I'm sure you will notice it more when we get to some of the other biomes too. But that is one thing they are working on to make everything look more pretty, and I am sure those of you who play the game and who are able to play it on higher quality, because I am currently playing on medium, you'll see a much greater effect than I do here. But it's always nice to see that they are working on this stuff. Another thing they changed, or they added, is an option to disable snapping. So we can, let's just do this. If we go over here, you should kind of snap. You're gonna snap for me? You don't wanna snap for me? Should snap for me. I wonder if their snapping changes made it not snap, because right now it's not snapping. Nope, it won't snap. Okay, well, then it's gonna be hard to show what I wanted to show, but if you hold C down, then that will prevent it from snapping, but right now it doesn't want to do anything at all of what I wanted. Huh. Come on. No? It won't snap for me. Okay, let's just place you right there, and let's see if this one will help me out. Not easy showing stuff off if it doesn't want to do what I want to do. Oh, what happened to my... Come on. There we go. Nice. Okay, so now we have a little wall here. Are you gonna let me... Okay, let's turn you around. Oh, snapping off. Oh, snapping on. You can actually see it in the bottom right corner that you, every time I hit C, now it's off and now it's on. That's kind of cool, actually, that they added that. The thing is, it just, it isn't snapping. okay. Well, it is a work in progress. It's something they are working on, all of this. And you also have to remember that these guys, it's their first game. Like, they are still learning a lot of stuff. They don't have like 20 years of experience in game development and coding, so they are actually doing an awesome job, because they always have to like learn a lot of this stuff and figure out how to solve everything and add features that people are requesting. Okay, well, it won't snap for me. Okay, but apparently it does do this. So if I hit C, now snapping is off. But yeah, the idea was that if you want to place something and you kind of want to maybe place it at a different angle, or in some cases, I know that people have been using these fences to actually place them on top of each other. And that suddenly wasn't possible anymore because it would snap. So, and the same if you want intentionally to, you know, place something without it snapping, that can make it really, really tricky if you want to have it at a different angle and it would just keep snapping for you. So now there's an option to disable snapping. Okay, and apart from that, they have also changed the damage of some animals and some mutants that has been increased to make things a little harder. The respawn time for all the enemies was doubled or tripled, so it'll take longer for them to respawn, which some people are probably gonna be happy about, so they don't respawn that fast when you are clearing a nest, for instance. They have also increased the time available to retrieve your arrows, so you have more time for that. I actually didn't feel like that was a problem anymore. It was right in the beginning with the game, it was like you would shoot something and before you even made it, even if you're running or even if you're almost next to what you're shooting at, the arrows would be gone. But I haven't really felt that lately. Of course sometimes they would despawn, but generally it hasn't been that hard. But anyway, it has been increased. The headshot damage was increased by 20% for bows, so now it matters if you shoot something in the head. That is pretty cool. Then they have lowered the mouse sensitivity by 50% when sniping. I'm kind of happy about that, because when I was trying to snipe something, the second you use the scope of the rifle, actually I have that right here, so if you right click, then this was just moving way too fast when I was trying to aim at something, and it does seem to be better now. So if we go out here, you can see I can move like this, right click. It does seem, we'll have to see when we test this out later, but it does seem to move slower now, which is cool because that was making it a little bit hard. They also updated the tutorial area. I'm not gonna check that out, but and I'm not sure what they updated, but we'll find out at some point. I'm sure I'm gonna jump into the game again at some point to show some stuff off there. They have updated loading screen tooltips. That is a good idea, because some of the tooltips were a little outdated maybe. Crouching was adjusted. So what has that been adjusted? How has that been adjusted, I wonder? I don't know. Maybe it seems to be a little bit more noticeable, because before I really thought it was hard to really feel if I was crouching or not. But I am not sure exactly what they have adjusted. I haven't used this much at all. What else have they do? They have increased the max stack of paper. That is helpful. And they have added blinking of the eyes for the horses. So I have never really thought about that, but look at that. I love that. What a nice little extra feature. I love all these little details. Makes them look more natural. Look at that. Oh my. Yeah, nice. Very sweet. Just a cute little detail. And as you can see, actually, let's just ride you out here a little bit, because they added something else. Let's actually do this, and let's go back in here, and then you go up to this one. Yep, slicey itchy. There we go. Come on, you're gonna follow me. Aha, look at that. Now you can make them follow you, which is very, very handy when you're out and about. If you are bringing a horse with you and you kind of just, you know, if you want to ride to one end of the biome and do some resource grinding, then you don't have to run back to find your horse again, or, you know, it will get lost for you. Well, it won't anymore because they are shown on the compass, but then you don't have to run back to them. You can just kind of go and say, itchy. There we go. We should be able to get to both of them. Look at that. See? Now they'll be following me. Ah, I wouldn't use that much here, I don't think. Well, maybe I will when I get more into building, but I can see the cleverness in this. When you're running around grinding resources, then you can just have the horses follow behind you, or the horse, and when you are kind of done and you want to get back to the balloon or a teleport fast, then you just jump on the horse. Isn't that cool? I love this. Look at that. Nice. Oh, you kind of pushed him. That was a little mean. Okay, well, let's just see if we can get these guys to come back in here. Yep, come on. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Nice, look at that. Oh, yep, they have... Oh, easy. Easy, you two. I do like all these very natural movements of them. Not that I'm much into horses in general, but there we go. Oh, I didn't mean to jump on top of you. Go, go. There we go. Dismiss. And now you guys should stay in there. Yep, look at that. Awesome. Yep, that is, I am sure that is a popular feature that a lot of people are gonna love, because that might even make me bring my horse along. Because usually I never bring horses when I'm out and about, because I like hoarding resources, and then I have to get off the horse hill all the time, and I feel like it's just as fast getting around on my 2 feet. But if I can bring a horse with me now, that might actually make me bring them. Because then when I'm far out there, I can just kind of get on the horse and ride back. Very handy. I am digging that. Another thing they have changed with this update is they have replaced the models for the Dobermans and the Greyhounds. And I must admit I haven't studied them that much, because I haven't placed that many of my animals down. So I'm not quite sure what the change is. I do feel like there's a change with these. I just thought I would go and check these out, because I knew they were right here in the cage. I do feel like the face is different on the Dobermans, at least, than before, but I haven't really studied them that closely that I can notice a change. But they have replaced them, and there's actually a new color available for the Greyhound. I am not sure where we'll find that, but I am sure we'll locate it at some point in the game, because I do love going exploring. I just want to check if there's anything new in here. We have the chickens, Staxhound, Doberman, Flexen, nope. No, I'm not seeing anything new. Okay. But, yep, that is one thing they have changed too. I do feel like it takes longer for things to spawn in now compared to, well, I have to go back and check my previous video from Carlsberg, but, but it is just because the grass has changed. It definitely looks different. Ah, interesting. It does seem like I can, well, it doesn't take longer. It actually loads in prior, I guess. It's just because it looks different. Huh. Interesting. Okay, well, I wanted to go down here and check something. Because I saw in the Discord earlier that our... Oh, it's just a barrel of some kind. Okay, I thought it was something like an animal or something along those lines. But let's just go over here and... Are you new? I thought I'd remove these. Okay, well, maybe I didn't. Oh, we got someone coming there. Okay, easy boy. Easy. There we go. Let's just deal with you. Huh. So I have something in the way there. Okay, let's run around this way then. Because I just wanted to pay the madman a little visit. Right over here. Yep. Oh, hello. Where are you guys coming from? I thought I had cleared out the ones right around here. Well, I guess I'll have to do that later. Yep, nice. Do that, and... Oh, come on. Yep, okay, look at that. He's got a new friend. Aha! Yep, I saw that in the Discord earlier, so... Look at that, and we have our nice little doggy here. Yeah, it does seem different than the old model, but honestly, I can't say exactly what is different. But I somehow like this better. I don't know, is the face a little bit wider or something? I am not sure, but I do like this. Very cool, but yes, he's got himself a new friend. Okay, so just to show you guys what it looks like, because I'm not sure if my PC can handle this. I tried to turn on, so I have high quality graphics, and I turned on both the special effects and the camera effects, and even anti-aliasing. I think the only thing I don't have turned on right now is ambient occlusion. I have no idea what that means. But yeah, there's definitely something happening here with the sun that doesn't usually happen. The grass looks very different. everything just looks very different. But it's not even because my PC is struggling that much at the moment, but I'm not sure I like this because that sunlight is just a little too bright, and I kind of feel like I'm getting, if I'm running through this graph or this grass, it gives me has the same effect as when I'm when there's motion blur in a game. It makes me motion, it gives me motion sickness kind of when I try to run through this grass. But I just wanted to see if my PC can actually handle it, and I think it's the special effects or something. That's at least my experience from the last time I turned that on. I kind of found out that that doesn't work for me. But it was just to give you guys a little view of what it looks like if you turn more stuff on. Wow, that sunlight is so bright. Ooh, okay. Okay, so I turned off the special effects. Yeah, I do see a difference, but I'm not sure. It might be the I think I can handle this better. It might be the special effects that bugs me with the grass and stuff, but I don't think I really like the camera effects either. Nope, this very bright light, I have to figure out what does that. It might be the camera effects actually that does that. But while I'm looking at this, for those of you who don't have the game yet and who might have been thinking about picking it up, right now might be a good time to do that if you feel like you have a problem with paying the full price or can afford the full price, because right now until the 5th of July when the summer sale ends, the game is 50% off, so it's 9.95 euros or something, it's around 10 euros for the game right now. So that is actually a nice amount to save, of course, if you want to pick up the game. And also, if you have a general interest in the game, if you play it or if you're thinking about playing it, and you have any opinion about how to implement farming, because that is something that will be coming to the game, farming or gardening or something, then do stop by the forums, because the developers started a thread there today with some questions and asking what people think about farming and how to implement it, mostly regarding how much time it takes for a crop to become ripe to harvest it. Well, I don't know if ripe is the right word for a crop, but yeah. It's mostly, you know, do you want to have plant something and it's ready in 4 in-game hours, or do you want to plant something and it's gonna take maybe a few in real-life hours, or maybe even more, or yeah, what's your opinion about that? And this is your chance to leave them some feedback. And yeah, I'm not too happy about that light. Okay, I'm gonna fiddle around with this some more. Okay, I turned off the camera effects too now, and I think this is actually, I think I prefer playing it with camera and special effects off. Still get this nice sunlight here, but it looks like I can actually play it fairly well on high graphics right now. It doesn't seem to lag that much, so that's a positive thing actually. Well, it's not like it usually lags that much for me. But I do get this, like, you know, a little bit, tiny bit, like I lose some frames per second or something. I don't know, but this seems to run fairly well right now. And yeah, the reason I'm kind of checking this out is also because I actually often get some questions from people asking about my camera or my my graphic settings, and you know, how to set them so that it runs the best. And all I can say is it's best to just play around with it and kind of try it out for yourself and see how it runs on your PC. Yeah, right now I do have anti-aliasing on, and I think it's something they're looking into finding a new one. or making a crafting, well, not crafting, making a new one, finding a new one. I don't know how all that stuff works, but they have changed it. They used to have one type of anti-aliasing, but it was a little too demanding performance-wise, so they changed it. But this one just doesn't look as nice as the old one. And one place where you can notice it is if you look at the horizon. You can see it looks a little bit choppy out at the ends. Actually, when I'm looking here, if you look to the sides of the horizon, it gets a little bit choppy. It's not something I usually notice that much when I'm just running around. But it's mostly when you are standing here at the... and looking out to sea that you will notice this little detail there. But that's something they're looking into. They want to see if they can implement a new anti-aliasing. I didn't know it was something you kind of implement that way, but apparently it is. And yeah, if you're wondering if you can run the game, if you don't have it yourself and you're like, ah, oh, I don't know, well, they did update actually the requirements. If you check the Steam page, they have just updated that this weekend, so there might be some changes. I don't remember what it said before, because I've never actually, my PC doesn't exactly meet the requirements. I think I have the, I think my CPU is okay, but it's not the best. I could definitely use a better one. My graphics card doesn't really meet the right requirements. But you can always check the bottom of the description for my videos if you want to compare your own with mine. Because I have them listed there, what my my specs are, if you want to see if there's, if you're uncertain if yours will be able to run the game. They do up... Oh, hello. Got a couple of deals there. They do update the game and optimize and change stuff all the time, so do always check back, because even if you it might not run that well for you now, then maybe a few months or 6 months or next year it will run better for you. Who knows? Oh, and yes, there is another, well, interesting thing about this update. And they added 3 new dog breeds. So there's the Great Dane, the Amstaff, and the Tatra Sheepdog. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. What are you? What kind of dog are you? Are you gonna attack me? I don't know. Let's just see. What are you? Hello, doggy. Huh. Are you like a sheepdog thingy? I don't know, but we found one. And I just wanted to show you guys at least one of them. Oh, you're gonna lie down. Hey, doggy. Okay, it's gonna be upset now because I'm gonna shoot it. Come on. Oh, okay, cool. Did it. Yay. Only needed one. Okay, a gray. Oh, so this is the new greyhound. I thought it looked a little bit like a greyhound. But okay, so that's the new color for the greyhound. Awesome. Ah. Very cool. I was kind of lucky. I just thought I would go through Green Hills and it was just right here in the middle of nowhere. Nice, because I thought maybe they would have added some of these new dogs to Green Hills. That's a thing when they add new animals to some of the biomes, then yeah, then you kind of have to go back and check the ones that you already cleared. Oh, I almost missed it. Look at this. There is a doggy here. Yep, we are right at the windmill in... look at you! Oh, look at that face! Oh, you're so cute! You're so cute! Come on, look up. Aw, you are such a cutie. Okay, so that is one of the new doggies. And yeah, let's just deal with you. Ooh, ooh. Yeah, you're not too happy about that, baby. I know. Okay, wow, that can get me into trouble. Ooh, if I could just hit you. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Easy. Easy, easy, easy. Nope, don't want to hit you with that. Come on. Ugh, it's so hard when they're so close. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Wow, come on. There we go. Got you. Wow, that was hard. Okay, well, let's just pick this up. Tatra sheepdog, white. Oh, so that's what a Tatra sheepdog looks like. Okay, well, cool. I found one. Yay! Oh, I definitely need to go through Green Hills, because I already went through Green Hills very, very intensely and very strategically trying to clear everything. So I spent like 7 episodes or something on that earlier in this season. But now I have a reason, of course, to go back and see if there are new animals. And so far I already found 2 doggies here that weren't there before. So, where did I actually... Well, I guess I left the horse down by the balloon, because I kind of spawned in all the way out on the other end, because I had used the ritual fire there the last time I was here. Anyway, that was 2 of the new dogs. There was the new collar for the greyhound, and this black one. Actually, that's a male. And then we have the Tatra sheepdog. She was actually female. She's actually rare. Nice. So that's probably not that many of them. It doesn't say unique. It does say rare. So there might be more. Hopefully, there's a male somewhere too. Because I am looking forward to when breeding is a thing. But yeah, I'm sure we'll find the other dogs later on, the Amstaff and the Great Dane, as we progress through the game. So let me know what you think, and what you think about the game, and if you're considering maybe picking it up yourself now that it is on sale, or what is holding you from picking it up, and that would be interesting to know. And yeah, as I mentioned, if you have any opinion about how farming should be implemented, do make sure to drop by the forums on Steam and leave your feedback for the developers, so they can take that into consideration, what everybody has to say. There's already quite a few people who's been leaving their ideas and suggestions, which is awesome. We do have a great fan base for this game. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.